How many times was Travis stabbed?
大家好，我是 Eric 长万年。朱迪系列的视频现在来到了第三部分，在警察两个多小时的审讯之下，朱迪现在出现了这样一种双手抱头的这种在 forensic psychology 领域叫做投降姿势的动作，同时开始关心起了特拉维斯身中多少刀。我们看他这是要招供了吗？
More than I want to remember. And I'm not going to sit here and show you pictures of him after the fact. I don't do that. That's not how I work.
朱迪的投降姿势出现之后，警察明显是觉得有希望，于是偷偷的移动这个椅子靠近他。可惜这个审讯室里面警察的这个椅子竟然不是有轮子的那种，所以他还得抬一下椅子这样去移动，动作很大。同时手呢也镜像的去学习朱迪现在这个动作，也从心理上跟对方去拉近距离。
I think you're feeling the reality in the moment now.
No, I'm just feeling all of the things that I'm going to potentially miss out on with my family, and I think of all the things that Travis's family is going to miss out on with Travis. And he had brothers and sisters, and I have brothers and sisters. And he...
哭是哭了，但是还是不忍，又把话题岔开了。而警察呢，唉，叹了一口气，他现在已经是听够了。后面警察告诉他，你被控谋杀，要被关进监狱，24小时之内你要去见法官。朱迪的回应我是没想到的，在这种时候了，他竟然想要收拾打扮一下。
But before they book me, can I clean myself up a little bit?
You're gonna be taken the way you are. I can't give you anything else.
哎呀，这一段看得我简直是匪夷所思，毛骨悚然。朱迪竟然在审讯室里面来了个倒立，然后像女巫一样很悠然的在唱着山歌。后期其实朱迪被问到为什么在审讯室里面倒立的时候，他说呢，他就是想看看地上的地毯，因为这很有可能是他最后一次看到地毯了。这个案件上了法庭之后，朱迪的律师也一直在强调他的精神有问题，其中就提到了他在审讯室里面这种反常的表现。平心而论，我从来没有人见过有人在审讯室里面有朱迪这样的夸张的行为，尤其是一个很明显他看上去是有罪的人。就目前我们看到的视频来讲，除了有那么一点点边缘型人格这样的影子以外，我其实看不出来朱迪有什么明显的人格问题。如果他是一个正常的心理健康的人，那现在在审讯室里面的行为更多的就可能是来自于他身上发生的这个事情给他带来的影响。换言之呢，他现在的表现更像是 PTSD， 是创伤后应激障碍。如果有律师在场的话，我相信这个律师一定会制止警察继续对朱迪审问的。第二天在监狱里待了一晚之后，朱迪被重新带回到了审讯室里面。这一次在经过前一天的充分接触之后，我们看看警察在审讯上面会有什么变化。一上来就有一个改变， 上期朱迪曾经问过身后的这些录音机，当时的警察说没有开。今天的这个女警来审他，本来已经都准备拉开椅子要坐下来，但又专门走过去把这个录音机拿过来，还摆在他的面前。我们看这段视频，收音是没有任何问题的。审讯室里面本来就配有录音录像设备，根本就不需要再多余的再摆一个录音机放在那里，所以这个动作完全就是做给他看的，很刻意的让他知道我们现在开始录音了。
Today's date is July 16th, and my name is Detective Rachel Blaney, and I'm here with Jody Arias. And before we go any further, I need to read your Miranda rights again, just to make sure that you understand. You have the right to remain silent. Do you understand?
这一上来啊，又很刻意的去说了时间和现场的人，然后很正规的给朱迪念了他的米兰达权利，故意把一切都弄得特别的正规，仪式感做足。
I have been privy to the investigation and all of the evidence in this case and to your conversation with Detective Flores yesterday. And
这里再很正式的跟朱迪说啊，我 privy to 就是我被允许知情，被允许参与啊你的案件，其实就在暗示自己的角色，我呢，我也是负责你这个案子的人。到目前为止，警察现在所有的操作都在传递着今天跟昨天不一样了的这个信号，人换了，开始录音了，我们今天谈话很正式，这些信号。其实我们看朱迪现在的这个姿势，这个姿势是审讯到目前为止朱迪首次出现，这个姿势其实还是主要出现在一个人无聊的时候，他又无聊又不能随便动的这个时候。那么在这种时候，我们就会意识到自己的这个头很重啊，所以想要用去手去撑着。但是朱迪为什么会无聊？回想之前见到那个男性警察的时候，朱迪的表现欲是很强的，各种搔首弄姿的动作很多。那这里他无聊了，有两个原因。第一，他面前是个女性，他平生所学都只对男性有用。第二，他在等那个男性的警察来，并没有把面前的这个女警当回事，他以为这个女警跟昨天一样啊，来这儿待一会儿之后就会走。然而根据目前的这个架势来看，今天要来审他的正是面前的这个女警。
There's no question in my mind or any of the other investigators' mind that you were the person that took Travis's life. This hits the news. And it will. It'll go to the media. Do you want to be portrayed as that cold-blooded, cold-hearted murderer? Because the media loves that. Or do you want to be portrayed as a person that didn't mean to have any of this happen? It just got out of hand, and you're remorseful. You know, of course I don't want to be portrayed as a cold-blooded murderer. I believe that. This is your opportunity to help yourself out. When the jury looks at it, those are the things that they're going to be mulling around in their mind when they decide what type of sentence to hand out or when they make a recommendation to the judge. I've never seen a case with so much concrete, hard evidence. We don't need you to tell us anything. I'm doing this for you. How can it help me? I mean, how can what I tell you today affect the media? You take control of the situation as much as you can and paint whatever kind of picture you want to paint of yourself. Nobody's going to believe that you didn't do it after they see the evidence. It's just, it is what it is. But it's a matter of, do you want to take control of your situation and paint the picture of who you are? Because you're the only one that knows that. Or do you want the media to take the evidence, all of the facts and the information, and paint their own picture of you? I don't feel like I have any control over what the media says anyway. Well, you do, to a certain degree. You can have the opportunity to tell your side of the story. Were you hoping for marriage? Because I've heard a lot of talk about, you know, possibilities of marriage, and I know that that is, a cornerstone of your faith, is marriage and family. Is this something that you were hoping for? Was he leading you down that path? Did he take advantage of you?
Were there promises made that were broken? Did he betray your trust in some way? I don't know. Only you know that.
受害者有罪论实际上是审讯室里面非常常见的一个方法了。这里警察试图把特拉维斯去塑造成一个背叛朱迪、占朱迪便宜的一个坏人、一个坏男人，这样实际上是给有罪的嫌疑人一个台阶下，给他们一个心中他们可以接受的一个招供的方案。
You're not going to have the opportunity to do this again.
What is your role, though? I mean, you're a detective.
大家是否能感觉出来，朱迪对于这个女警是非常有敌意的？这里还特意的去问了他的角色，大家看他的面部表情似乎也是皱着眉头的，显示出来一丝的这个不耐烦，身体语言上呢呈现出来的是一个无聊的感觉。在他的心中，负责他案件的还是那个男警官，他实际上现在也是在等那个男警官过来。
This is our jurisdiction, it's our county, so you know, part of this investigation, if you will, is on us.
Can I ask you a couple questions?
Sure.
Not personal questions. I know, I understand they took some of my stuff yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
Where does all that go? Does it go to Arizona?
It'll be transferred to Arizona. It's held in evidence. There's a list of everything that was taken and...
Like my camera, for example.
Mm-hmm.
Which is fine. I understand that. My concern is other people. For example, I'm a wedding photographer and I just did a wedding on Friday. And I feel bad for Brian and his wife, Katie, because those are their wedding pictures. That's all they have for their wedding.And I just want to know when they'll be able to get their wedding pictures.
他被控谋杀了，现在他担心他作为一个摄影师啊，相机上面别人婚礼的照片被警察没收了。这个敬业的简直是令人发指，他一再的在一些很不重要的事情上面搞得非常的情绪化，很难不让人觉得这个情绪是假的。昨天对于那个男警官，他就没少这么干，显示自己是一个楚楚可怜的，是一个无辜的小女孩一样的个感觉。朱迪说白了就是一个逃避的心态，反正我不想谈那个案件的那件事情。既然非得说点什么话的话，那咱们就说点别的吧。说什么呢？咱们说一点让别人觉得我很可怜啊，我很善良啊，我很关心别人，这样给我自己去塑造一个好的形象。这个招数他应用的特别的熟练，从昨天到今天也用了很多次了，相信他在生活中应该也是有很多次的通过这种方法去脱离麻烦、脱离困境的这个经验。但是面对一个警察，并且这个警察还是个女警官的时候，这招不会有用的。
I think you're not grasping the reality of the situation, and hearing, you know, what your concerns are, you should be concerned for yourself right now. You should be fighting for yourself. I was just hoping to give you the opportunity to show the world, to show the community, to show the jury, to show Travis's family.This is the time to take control more than you've ever done before. And at least show the people that you love and care about that you have remorse and that you have a heart. Because when they sit there and they see somebody that's just stone cold and saying they didn't do it when it's clear to everybody that you did, that's what they're going to see, is a stone cold person.This is your opportunity to change that. You can't change what happened. You can't go back and undo it. It's a done deal. But hopefully you're smart enough to realize that you can have a little bit of control of how you're portrayed.
Cognitive reframing, 认知重构是在心理治疗中间非常常用的方法之一啊。在审讯室里面现在实际上应用也是越来越广泛了。认知重构听起来逼格很高，实际上就是换一个角度，或者说换一个方式来看问题。一般嫌疑人心中想的是我有没有那个万分之一的可能性能够逃脱惩罚。其实在朱迪这个案件里面，警察所掌握的证据已经非常多了。本来13个小时的路程，他开了48个小时，手机刚好就在特拉维斯所在的这个城市附近没电了，离开那个区域马上就找到充电器，手机马上就有电了。特拉维斯家里的照相机里面不仅有他们当晚亲密的照片，甚至还有朱迪出现在尸体旁边的照片。朱迪家里丢了枪，特拉维斯身上中枪，子弹呢是同一种。在这么多证据面前，朱迪能够狡辩的余地非常的小，他不可能有无罪的说法。但是减轻刑罚的说法呢，实际上还是有的。那么无非就三个方向：第一，我疯了；第二，我在，但这个事不是我干的；第三呢，是 我在也是我干的，但不是我想干，是有人逼着我干的，诱导我干的。那不管是哪一个，他都逃脱不了关系。所以警察说你尽早招了，对你的形象有好处。具体的原因你自己后面慢慢再想嘛。大家注意，警察现在依然是隔着桌子在去审他，没有打算逼近他，给他去施压，实际上也就是在给他时间让他去想。顺便提一句啊，上期我的视频底下有一个网友留言问，警察为什么不用 Chris Watts 那个案件里面警察那个审法啊？问他说是不是意外，这样是不是他更好的，他心中可以接受的一个说法。意外啊，确实是一个很好的说法，对于大部分的嫌疑人来说也是一个他良心上可以接受的一个说法。但是我们也要看情况，你意外窒息啊，你意外枪走火了，这都有可能，哪有人意外身中28刀的。
You know, were angry or upset or disappointed, betrayed, whatever the emotion was, and things got out of control.
We both have betrayed each other, but it was so long ago, you know? The last time we even talked about marriage on a serious level was when we were still dating over a year ago. Mm-hmm. And the last time, you know, he proposed to me once, he proposed to me a lot of times, but he wasn't always serious. He just kind of said it, marry me, you know, as a joke.
And how did that make you feel when he said marry me as a joke? I mean, did you want it?
No, and not after we had broken up. It was kind of like laughs. Like, it's really kind that he would joke like that. We would laugh. You know, so marriage, as much as I love Travis, I just have always, there's something inside that says he's not the guy you're going to marry.
So then what was it? What was it that led up to all of this? I mean, there's got to be something. So I honestly don't believe that, you know, that you're cold-hearted and you would just go and just, you know, kill somebody on a whim. That doesn't fit your profile. So what was it that led up to that? You know, you tell me. You tell them. You tell, you know, Travis's family. What was it that, you know, pushed you to your limit? You know, what was it that would make you, you know, so angry or upset?
这一段是审讯心理学上面讲的 theme development。警察呢会做各种的假设，讲各种的故事，这里就是一个假设，实际上就是啊，特拉维斯是个坏人，是个负心汉，他玩弄了你的感情，使你生气了，冲动了啊，导致你干了这个事情。这个 Rachel 女警官呢明显是有心理学的背景的，这句话一说就听出来了，与昨天男警官很强调证据不同，他在前一天失败的这个基础上特别着重于情绪方面的沟通。那个事情给了你什么感觉？他做了什么事情让你感觉这么差？尤其是我觉得他采取这样一个被动语态的问法是非常的好。 How does that make you feel? 那个给了你什么感觉，而不是一个主动的语态。 How do you feel about that? 你对那个有什么感觉？这里主要的区别就是发生过的所有的事情全都是被动的。求婚了然后说我在开玩笑，这给了你什么感觉？那天发生了这个什么事情导致了那个什么结果，什么事情导致了你这么生气，全是被动的。而没有发生的事情，还没有发生的事情都是主动的。你告诉我，你告诉他们，你抓住机会等等。过去发生的事情已经发生了，你无法改变，而且你不是故意的，你是被动的，你是被逼的。而现在要发生的事情，将来发生的事情，你是可以控制的，你可以改变你的形象，你要主动的去叙述。警察随后出去了一下，我们知道警察每一次说要休息，每次出审讯室大多是要跟隔壁正在看监控的其他的那些同事去商量一下下面应该怎么去审，而很多审讯的策略也是从离开房间之后再重新回来开始。那么来看看警察有什么改变，打算怎么办。
Jody, I'm really confused. Maybe I did have a wrong picture of you. You know, all of this time that you and I have been talking and I got information from your other interview, you are talking about insignificant things at this point. You're talking about money, you're talking about material things, you're talking about everything but...
I'm just talking you're about talking things about that just people I care
about. You're talking about everything but... how bad you feel about Travis. You only respond to my questions.
If I were in Travis, I would be very remorseful.
I think that I've gotten the wrong picture of you. I think that, maybe I was wrong. Maybe you are that cold-blooded person. that they're trying to portray. And, you know, I'm just really confused. At this point, you know, maybe you're right. Maybe there isn't anything that you can do to help yourself.
警察一回来就启用了一个非常强硬的方法来跟他对线，他肯定是有目的的。我们接着看。
Maybe you weren't the person that did it. Maybe you just were physically there when it happened and somebody else did it. I mean, I guess, you know, that's a possibility. If that's the case, you know, help us out here. Help yourself out. If you didn't do it, then who did? Because everything is pointing to you, not just pointing to you, but, you know, screaming that Jody killed Travis. And I thought that I could come in here and talk to you and talk some, you know, sense into you and get you to, you know, kind of help yourself out. You don't need to help our case out. You don't need to help their case out. That's a slam dunk.
两个点说一下。第一，这个 slam dunk 是翻译过来是灌篮啊，这是一个审讯界的术语，它有两个意思。第一呢，是已经拿到了足够的口供，调查可以结束了。第二呢，是一种审讯的策略，属于 establish identity， 是身份自证法的一个更激进的一个版本。你不管说什么，我都说这事儿就是你干的。你怎么说，我都说是你干的。你否认，我就否认你的否认，我就往死里顶你，我就说是你干的。这里警察明显是第一个意思啊，就是我跟你其实没什么好谈的，这个调查已经结束了，已经搞定了。不过同时，我觉得他现在用的也是 slam dunk 的这个方法，估计下面呢，这个警察会一直很强硬的去怼他。第二呢，是跟 Chris Watts 中间警察提出，是不是你老婆杀了孩子，你才不得已去杀了你老婆，导致你全家灭门了一样。警察看他半天什么都不说，也给了他一个他良心上能够接受的故事，是不是你只是一个目击者，是别人干的。我们看到朱迪跟当时的 Chris 一样，在听到这个说法的时候就陷入了沉默，陷入了一个呆滞的状态。他这个时候实际上也是在考虑这个口供的可行性。
And what I'm hearing is somebody who doesn't give a rip about what happened. I'm hearing somebody that's worried about money, your appearance, everything about you. I don't hear anything about Travis unless you're specifically askedHow do you think that looks?
Listen, I don't care so much.
No, you listen. You are not grasping the reality here, Jody. You know, you're worried about wedding pictures and, you know, all this other stuff that is really insignificant.
Listen, my life is over. Travis's life is over. I'm sorry about Travis. I didn't take his life.
All right, well, I guess I was wrong.
The reason I cared about those other things is because those people still have lives, and I care about those people. And I just, they don't know where their stuff is, you know? I happen to be in possession of their stuff, and so...
All I know is all of the innocent people that I've talked to that have been accused of a crime don't act the way that you do. And you are acting like the person that I portrayed, the ugly...cold-blooded murderer. I mean, do you think you're going to get this opportunity again to sit down and just have a free-form discussion? There's not going to be any situation or place that's going to make it any easier for you. This is as good as it gets for you right now.
Yesterday, Detective Flores asked me if I wanted to see those pictures, and I told him no.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that's going to help you?
I don't know.
Well, I'll tell you what, let me check and see if we can get you some pictures to look at. I'll be right back.
朱迪这个时候提起了想看照片，他提起这个事情的方式是很有意思的。任何一个交过女朋友的男生，或者说女生自己，都应该能明白他说话的这个方式啊。昨天那个警察问我要不要看照片，我告诉他我不看。实际上我们知道他昨天后来是有要求看的。警察问他，你觉得看照片对你有帮助吗？他说，我不知道。其实这都是在故意的在说反话。不过话说回来，嫌疑人主动的要求看照片，这个举动呢并不常见。不知道他这里是不是又是为了自己塑造自己的人设，还是什么，有什么别的目的，我们下面再接着看。
Jody, Detective Flores has the binder with those pictures. and he's not here in our office right now, but I put a call in to try and find him and get him back here. He's still in town, he's just not here. Would you rather talk to him?
昨天在审朱迪的 Flores 警官作为他的这个案件的主要负责人肯定是在隔壁在看监控的，这都什么，这这么关键的时候他还能有什么别的事情，能去哪里，他又不是本地人，为什么要搞这么一出呢？感觉还是啊，一不想给他看照片，他既然提出来了没弄清楚为什么之前不能给他看，第二就是今天这个女警明显是怼他的，这已经怼了两个半小时了，效果还是不明显，这估计还是为了后面换人去铺路。根据昨天审讯的情况来看，朱迪可以对那个男警官撒娇，可以搔首弄姿，男警官呢也大概率的会比这个女警温柔很多，这一点就有点类似于 Mark and Jeff， 就是俗称好警察坏警察的这个方法，女警过来伤害他，男警过来拯救他，这个在审讯心理学上叫做 Hurt and Rescue Principle， 就先把你扔水里了，然后我再找个人给你捞上来，效果怎么样呢？我们接着看。
I don't really have preference, I guess. I kind of do want to talk to him because he has been in contact with, with Travis's family a lot.Okay. I don't know if that would make any difference, but I know that he already talks to them on a regular basis.
Yeah, and I'm sure that, you know, he has a, somewhat of a relationship with them.
Hey. Oh, Rachel called me and told me that you wanted to talk to me. You know, I told you yesterday, I've been doing this for a long time, and you're absolutely right. You know, the person's family who was hurt...They're obviously hurting, but there's a second family that hurts as well. And in this case, it's your family. Your brothers, your sister. Your mom, your dad.
挺明显的吧，大家应该很明显能感觉到这个男警说话呢就是非常的温柔，比那个女警要温柔的多，也比较顺着他的意思在说。
Rachel said something about you wanting to see some photos, but I don't think I can show you any more photos.
Why not?
Not just... I don't like doing that.
The reason I asked was because I just feel like it might help me piece some things together. And this is a more of a selfish reason. I think it might give me some sense of closure. I know it's kind of morbid.
Is it the photos before it happened that you want to see?
I think the photos of after everything.
I won't show you those. I won't, and not in good conscience. I can't do that. If you want, I can describe stuff for you.
What about photos of just the room with him not in it? I don't know. Maybe it's...
朱迪这个时候又提出来想要看现场的照片，尤其是特拉维斯遇袭后的照片，甚至还说只看房间的照片就行。他这么执着于想看照片，一定有鬼。猜测他可能是想要确认什么事情吧。在后面的这15分钟，他不停地找借口想要看，但是这个要求警察是不会答应他的。
I've got the images in my head, and I can explain whatever it is you want.About what I saw when I went there. What I can't do is I can't show you pictures.
在之后的一个小时中间，朱迪一方面跟昨天一样不停地在东拉西扯，但另外一方面他又时不时地陷入这种沉默。在审讯室这种场合，嫌疑人为了保持他在警察心中的某种形象，一般来说行为上不会出现巨大的变化。如果有对比这么明显的变化的话，那肯定是有原因的。参考他这种时常会陷入到呆滞的这个行为，就另外我们看 Chris Watts 那个案件的朋友应该也记得，他当时在审讯室里面也有类似的行为，联系他一直想要看现场照片的这个举动，不得不让人觉得他正在心里编造一份假的口供。警察在这个案子里面犯的最大的错误就是给出来了太多的证据了，总是有人认为证据越多啊，这个审讯就越好审，不能说没有关系，但是这个想法绝对是错的。这里就因为朱迪知道警察知道什么，所以他心里有底，他反倒不慌。如果他不知道警察手上有什么，他反倒还不好编。但现在呢，他就可以非常有根据的、有底气的去想自己应该怎么应对。而这个局面就是因为警察有太多证据，并且给出太多证据造成的。
You have to explain to me what happened. Otherwise, it was just you. And if that's the case, that's okay. That's okay as well. If somebody else was there with you, we need to know that. Why would somebody do that? Just because you're there with Travis?
He didn't say.
He didn't say?
They.
What was the first thing they did to him? You were there. You saw it. What was the first thing
you saw? I actually didn't see it. I heard it. Is there any way I can see those pictures? I just...
No, not right now.
Can I see them soon? I will. No.
You need to start letting me know what happened. Okay. You're telling me that some other people were there. You know how much that concerns me.
Or they know where my parents are. Or I don't know if they know where my grandparents are, but they got my address. And they know where my family is.
Mm-hmm. You're saying somebody followed you all the way to Arizona from here?
No, I don't think that. I think I was an element of surprise for them.
Is it someone who lives in Mesa locally?
I didn't recognize them yet.
Well, you have to give me a motive. Why would they do this? Were they going after Travis? For what reason?
朱迪这个时候就说的这个感觉就是貌似说、哦、做这个事情呢是另有其人，并且好像这伙人还知道他住在哪里，他家人住在哪里。其实警察这里一两个具体的问题就把他问住了，他假意抱着头啊去假装崩溃，实则呢是想打一个时间差去想清楚其中的一些细节该怎么说。我为什么这么说呢？大家再接着往下看。
You tell me this but you give me no reason.
They didn't discuss much. They just argued.
About what?
About whether or not to kill me.
For what reason?
Because I'm a witness.
A witness of what?
Him. Of Travis.
Of Travis's murder.
Yeah, but I didn't really witness it. Didn't see much. Just...
Why would they do this to him? What were they arguing about? What did they say? Their details.
They didn't say a lot. They were white Americans from what I could tell. They had, what do you call those things? They're like beanies, but they cover your whole face. And you've got like holes for your nose and in your mouth, in your eyes. And they were, one was black. I think they were both black or maybe dark blue or something. Anyway, it wasn't until I was in LA and Laura wasn't getting back to me and it was already like 9 something. I was like, maybe I will just go see Travis briefly. And I called Ryan and said, my phone was about to die. But he has a virus on his computer, so when you click the start menu on Windows XP or newer with 2000 or whatever, you have like my music, my pictures, my computer.
Yeah.
You can usually click on my computer and then go to the disk drive and open that. I said, I have this, I saw this thing in a Calvin Klein ad once that looked really good. And so he was, you're right, he wasn't very comfortable at first. He goes, he's standing there and he's all, I feel gay.
朱迪这里又开始了他的经典混乱叙事，跳来跳去的。在后面的半个小时里，朱迪告诉了警察当时现场的情况。我先不跟大家说当时到底发生了什么，我先给大家看警察最终听完之后的反应。
I've done this for a long time and this is the most far-fetched story I've ever heard and it's not going to help you.
先别管朱迪说的是个什么故事，我要是这个警察，我最关心的就是三个问题。第一，如果不是你干的，你为什么当时不报警？第二，如果是别人干的，为什么你活下来了？为什么他们已经杀了个人了，要留你一个活口？第三，也是最要命的一个点，我不知道朱迪是不是已经忘了这个事情了，还是他以为警察不知道。在特拉维斯死后的6个小时，他有给特拉维斯打过电话，并且留下了一段很长的语音留言。
So I already talked to her, so you can call her back if you want, but it's not necessary. My phone died, so I wasn't getting back to anybody. And I drove 100 miles in the wrong direction, over 100 miles, thank you very much. So yeah, remember New Mexico? It was a lot like that, only you weren't here to prevent me from going into the three digits, so fun. Tell you all about that later. Also, we were talking about, when we were talking about your upcoming travels my way, I was looking at the May calendar, so I'm all confused. But Heather and I are going to see Othello on July 1st, and we would love for you to accompany us. I don't know when Team Freedom's event is, though, but, you know, it's on the list, so we could do Shakespeare, Crater Lake, and the coast. So if you can make it. If not, we'll just do the coast and Crater Lake. But let me know, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.
End of message.
这个留言留的信息量是相当的大，说的内容也有点太多了些吧，听上去给我的感觉就是留给一个以后可能短期内不会再见面的一个人，有点在总结一切的这个感觉。并且关键是他为什么要给一个已经在他面前刚刚没命的人留言，这内容怎么听也不像是给一个死人留言吧。因为时长的原因呢，我们这期就先到这里了，预知后事如何我们下周再接着看。我是 Eric 长安万年，感谢大家的关注，也欢迎对这个案件感兴趣的新观众去点击下方的订阅按钮去订阅关注我的账号。好，我们下期再见了，拜拜。